Ambassador Ranjit Rai, please.
Yeah, thank you, sir. And it's really a pleasure to be on this panel. Thank you, hosts. So I'm so glad that, these discussions have intensified between our two countries. And, you know, this will really promote greater trust, greater understanding of each other's point of view. So, you know, some general and broad points I want to make. You know, first, Dr. Bhatt said, and the chair also mentioned, you know, our relations with Nepal are very, very diverse and very, very strong, and also interdependent. So there is mutual benefit that both countries receive from this relationship. And, you know, whenever you have such strong, even intimate relations, you have problems from time to time. And I think the challenge is to try and resolve these problems before they, fester into big disputes. And both sides really have to nurture the relationship. As Dr. Bhatt said, you know, Nepal has changed. There have been so many revolutions. There's a new political system. India has changed. It is now, one of the largest economies in the world. The world has changed. We are seeing the pandemic, the rise of China, the, problems in the West and China. And obviously all these impact on, happening in our own neighborhood. And as was mentioned, there are new youth generations with new aspirations. So clearly, frameworks in the past to deal with that relationship in order to further change. I know for a fact that Nepal has been in the 1950 treaty review, and our view has been that we can understand Nepal's desire to benefit from both China's growth and India's prospects. So I don't think anybody in India objects, it's not for us. This is really, Nepal is a sovereign country. It's for Nepal to decide what to do. But what tends to worry people in India is that, when there's a problem between Nepal and India, say Nepal has a problem with India, the default position seems to be turning to China. And, given the state of India-China relations, this plays out in a certain way in our, in the Indian public domain. And obviously this then tends to impact on our bilateral relations. And of late, our media has also spoken a lot about the more intrusive role played by China in Nepal's domestic political processes. I mean, this again is something for the Nepalese leaders and public to decide. But, there is a certain unease in India at the role in terms of, domestic political issues and factors in Nepal. But I think Nepal is best placed really to handle these issues. I just wanted to flag, some of the unease that people in India have, and, especially if, many, many friends of Nepal. So, sir, I think I'll stop there and will be happy to take, questions.
Thank you, Ambassador Rai. I think one or two aspects which you mentioned are very interesting. One is, I think you said India can make many gestures on smaller issues and resolve them. The problem is, why is India not doing it? I mean, this is where the whole question which Nepalese raise is legitimate.